Welcome back. Welcome back. Another day, another video, for our team comic book style videos, team video. We're talking about the Houston Rockets today, the hottest team in basketball, 10 in a row, just beat the OKC Thunder, like just really good ball club right now, fighting for their life right now to get into that play-in. And I think they will get there. I think Golden State's looked a little rough as of late, and the Rockets just look unbeatable at this moment, which is crazy to say, consider they're missing Sengun, which is wild. But it's been behind the back of two main guys, to say the least. Jalen Green, I mean, we'll start with him and then we'll move on to Amen Thompson, because I don't want him to get overshadowed here because he's been balling too. But Jalen Green averaging 30 in his last 10 games. Like, the guy is doing it on unreal splits, 55% from the floor, 46 from three. Ever since he became a dad, he's been hooping different.
Mm-hmm. Got to go out there and feed the family. I seen a thing that said that he got on the jet. He said, we're about to win 10 straight. And it was on video, and then they won 10 straight. That's the kind – I'll put my money on that guy. I love guys that do stuff like that. And like you said, you know what I'm saying, just had his kid playing for his family. This is the Jalen Green unlocked that I think the Rockets thought they were getting into when they drafted him. And this is the Jalen Green that looks like his high school mixtape. Like, this is the guy that I thought they were getting, and this is the guy I think a lot of people thought they were getting.
That's a fact. And me personally, I'll just say the way that he's been balling, you could say that he's looking better than Ja Morant. I don't know. Ja's tough. You know, I'm 12. He's 12.
You're going too far with this already.
But just taking into consideration how he's been balling, like, these past 2 weeks.
I don't think you're going far enough.
A little bit. You even Anthony Edwards. I don't know. I'm not.
No. Don't do that.
But look, Rockets fans either are gonna hate you for this or love you for it.
They're gonna love me for it. What are you talking about? Come on. Literally, I think that Jalen Green is showing you a level of consistency that we aren't seeing from, you know, a lot of players who have the potential to be superstars in the next following seasons who are as young as he is. You know what I'm saying? I think that he's showing you a level of consistency that is able to lead his team and also close out big games, especially against number one, number two, number three seeds. So I want to see how they hold up against Denver if they play them, you know, at any point for the rest of the season. But I'm definitely excited to see those cats. The Warriors need to watch out. Before I let y'all get back into it, I don't know if y'all saw Tari Eason's post on his story on Instagram, but he said, Warriors, come out to play. I know the Warriors fan base is going to see that. And that ain't – he poking the bear right there. You know what I'm saying? So I believe that they – you know, the Warriors need to watch out, but that may be a little catalyst to some stuff going down. Y'all better watch out.
Yeah, I'll read through Jalen Green's last five games. 37, 9, and 7. Then 26, 6, and 3. 41, 4, and 4. 26, 4, and 3. 42, 10, and 3. Those are his last five games.
And let me say against
some bad comp except for the Thunder. The Thunder is the game he had 37, 9, and 7. So, I mean, the rest of the games were against bad teams, but, like, it's just one of those things where you just see a guy when they're in that rhythm, and normally it lasts for a game or a few. He's just in it right now, and it doesn't seem like it's going to slow down. Like, they just play a lot faster and more fluid, I feel like. I haven't watched a ton of Rockets this season until lately, so I just feel like they're playing really fast and loose without Sengun. Not saying Sengun's a net negative for them, but they're just playing a different kind of style, what more perimeter oriented, which can be beneficial for a time. And I think it's one of those things where it's new and it's like fresh, and so teams don't really know how you're going to guard it yet, which I think will come eventually. But right now, I mean, they look unbelievable.
A couple of things I'll say about Jalen Green. A, he's scoring out of double teams. So it's not like, I get they're playing bad teams, but it's not like he's getting cake layups or open jumpers. He's scoring off the dribble. He's creating his own shot. He's scoring out of the double team. And these 40 and 37 and whatever point games are loud points. It's not like a quiet 40. It's big dunks. It's big step backs. He's turning around. The whole place is going nuts. You feel that guarding that.
And he just outdueled Shea. He just outdueled Shea.
But you, I'm saying though, the way that he's doing it, you feel it more than a quiet dude who's just hitting some open. Like he's actually doing people in bad. And he said he was going to do this. I told you when he got on that plane, he said, "I guarantee," or he didn't say I guarantee, but he said, "We're about to go get 10. And who else is going to say that and win 10 games in a row? He's a gamer. He's definitely a gamer.
Yeah, I mean,
no, don't do that.
We'll rotate over to a different guy on the team that I think deserves to get a little more love, who's been also playing great basketball. Men Thompson. Coming out of the draft, I thought he was going to be solid for them. And I saw, obviously, they signed Fred VanVleet. I'm like, oh, he's not going to get much burn. I didn't really know much about him coming out of the draft. I like the profile and everything like that. But it's been totally different than what I was kind of expecting. I know that was kind of not what it was going to be. Like, I knew he was going to be an athletic guard that couldn't really stretch the floor. But he's doing things that are like the hustle plays that I think Ime has really gotten out of him. Like, just last game in 40 minutes, 25, 15, and 4 with one turnover. Like, that kind of stuff, and it's all on great efficiency generally because they're all at the hoop. But still, I mean, you're driving the lane. You're getting into position to get these shots. Like, they're not just coming to – like, you're not going to, like, shoot pull-up threes right now. You're not at that point. And if he can get a three-point shot, I mean, Jesus Christmas, this guy's going to be unbelievable. But, like,
he has so much time to develop, and they have a great player development staff over there. And I think Ime is also a player's coach, just like we were talking about Jason Kidd last video. If you haven't checked the Mavs video, go check it out. Like, comment, subscribe. But they got a good player development system over there. Top five in the league, I believe.
That shout out to Amin Thompson, crazy prospect. Based off of his athleticism, he has so much potential to, you know, shine even brighter, especially if he develops a three-point percent, you know, a stronger
shot.
Three-point.
Yeah. A shot, to be honest.
But would you think? Would you think that he could? Like, I don't see why.
The form looks fine. Like mechanically, it looks fine. It's just a matter of, I mean, it takes time to get the confidence to be able to do it.
It's the Zoe treatment. You're a great shooter your whole life, or not a great shooter, but you're in high school. You can make threes, whatever. You move to the NBA, it's a little bit different. It's a little bit further. Guys are jumping a little bit higher. You work out with the shooting coach. You get dialed in off the court, and then you lock in on the court. You see a couple go in and a couple more go.
Yeah, the guy's 19 or 20. Like, it's not going to be tomorrow. But, like, I think this team in a few years, especially with this core, like, you're going to have Sengun, you're going to have Jalen Green, you're going to have Amen Thompson. Maybe Dylan Brooks and Fred VanVleet are still on the team at that point. Fred VanVleet will be because he signed the longest fucking contract ever.
He signed a beat-ass contract.
They're not getting rid of Dylan Brooks either. I think that Dylan Brooks has, you know, shown so much 3-and-D guy. You'll take it. You know, any team will take a 3-and-D guy. And I think with the core that they already have right now, please, Houston fans, I see you. But everybody else, don't forget about Jabari Smith Jr.
Like,
I think
they're going to have guys forever right now. Like, as long as you can keep these guys re-signed, like, it's going to get better. And, like, you're seeing the flashes of it now. And I'm not saying that it's going to be this season or next season. But I'm saying next season, your hope is you get to a playoff spot. Like, I think that's where you want to go. Or even this season, if you can continue this hot stretch and get into the playoffs, that's a huge success for this season, especially from where you were at the trade deadline. But, I mean, like, just going back to Amen Thompson to kind of put a bow on it, in his last 70, he's multiple 20-and-10 games. Like, he's rebounding the shit out of the ball. And it's also, you're losing some of that rebounding with Sengun. So who steps in? Oh, your 6'7 point guard. Like,
right. Yeah.
Like, it's just unbelievable. And
his ceiling's OD.
Yeah, like, it's his defense is elite. Like, the Rockets are defending teams, too. Like, don't get it twisted. Like, they're off Jalen Green and Amen Thompson offensively and great. Their defense has been flying around.
They're young. They got springs in their legs. And let's not forget, I know Sengun hasn't been part of the run. In my personal opinion, and we said this last year, Matt was a big picketer of Sengun. This is a generational talent we're talking about. This guy could be the cornerstone of any franchise. In my personal opinion, he really has it like that.
Yeah, no, like, I think we're going to see in the future a similar kind of dynamic. And I hope it honestly gets to this point because I would love to watch it for the next 10, 15 years. Is kind of what Jamal Murray and Nikola Jokic have. Like, that's entirely possible. And I know it's insane comparisons because neither of those guys are at that point yet. But, like, it's coming. Like, you see
how old is Sengun?
I look, but 24? Like it's coming. Like
Sengun, how old is Sengun?
I'm looking it up. I was trying to fill
I lagged a little bit. I think he's like 24.
Holy cow.
He's 21. He's my fucking age.
No way.
Yeah.
He's wild. Developed. Pause. He's strong though.
And
yeah,
let's give some love boy. To Tari Eason too. Tari Eason's one of those cats. I think that you got a lot
under 22.
All you got a lot of development. You got a lot of development and you got a lot of runners and they make it to the play-in. It's going to be a lot of disruption and I better watch out.
Yeah, my thing is, okay, so I hope they get in the play-in, not only because I think based on how they've been playing they deserve it recently, but also it's one of those steps now. Like before that, without the play-in, it was like get into the playoffs and then lose a round and then lose in the second round and then lose in the conference finals and you get to the finals eventually. And it's like a long process to get there. Don't get me wrong. But now at the play-in, you can get a one game or two game sample size of a playoff type atmosphere. And you're also going to be getting it against some of the best vets in the NBA, in NBA history. You're going to be getting most likely the Lakers, the Suns. At this point, you might even get the Clippers with how bad they're playing. You'll get the Warriors, maybe. I think they'll bump the Warriors out because the Lakers are playing good too right now. But like, you're going to be able to play against some of the best vets and manipulators of the game of basketball in recent memory. So like, it's just going to be huge. Like that's something that you want for a team that's young and upcoming. Like they're all under 22. It's wild.
The West is wild, and having teams like that are on the come up on similar timelines is just fun to watch, bro.
Like they've drafted well and they're starting to see it come together. Jabari Smith is starting to look like the Jabari Smith people thought he was going to be coming out of college. We get to see Tari Eason, as Slim mentioned before, really start to fill in his role. We get to see Sengun kind of take the reins for a little bit, and now it's Jalen Green's turn right now while he's out. And you're seeing guys like Amen Thompson start to figure out the NBA game a little bit and not just be like a raw athlete out there who's just running around. Like he's starting to figure the game out, which is super clutch. And Slim, make your point. We'll wrap it up.
Not only young cats, not only rebounders, not only runners, but veteranship. And nice. They have veteranship in Fred VanVleet, who has a history in winning and playing at the highest level. And the boy going to give you 35. You know what I'm saying?
Not anymore.
Him and Jalen Green just combined.
I know, but like, it's Fred VanVleet.
Watch out.
Not a Fred VanVleet guy. Sorry, Rockets fans. But no, Slim's right. It's part of the process. You draft well, and you get a guy or two, and you found two of them. And then you go. Go ahead, Slim.
And Jeff Green. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. So
I miss Uncle Jeff.
You draft two, three guys that you think could be cornerstones of your franchise going forward. You let them lose for a season or two and you'd be like, they realize this shit sucks. So then you go and you sign guys to absurd contracts, which is just how you have to do it, to be honest. No veteran's going to want to come and play for your team for a vet minimum. They're just not. They're going to want to be able to get a little bit over that. You paid a guy like Fred VanVleet and Dylan Brooks a lot of money. But hey, in the offseason, when we talk about these signings and we said this team could be on the rise, an impossible playoff threat, play-in threat, we said that these signings, they look bad to everyone else outside, but it's so important for their development as a team. So important. Now you're going to get the chance to go to the play-in. Right. Now you're going to get that chance.
And I'd love to see them, I mean, this is getting a little bit scandalous. I'd love to see them steal a game.
Yeah, I'd love for them to get in the playoffs. It'd be fun. Why not? Fuck it. I mean, they'll lose Denver in the first round, but it'll be fun.
You're getting soft, man. You're getting old. Why not? I'd love to see it. No, I would.
I would. Okay. Why not?
I would do. I would too.
But yeah, like, comment, subscribe. Check out our other videos. Turn that bell on. Merch on the way.